All right, today is turn signal day. I ordered these 3/4 inch LED marker turn signals on Amazon. They come with bullet connectors. So I had to go to AutoZone, pick up some female end for the bullet connectors. Comes with 14. So I think I'm gonna need 12. 3, 6, 9, 12. So here we go. These stock lights haven't worked in a while, but they have new bulbs, but I know it's not the bulbs. I know it's these connectors inside here are so corroded. It's not even funny. So what I'm gonna have to do is pull all this string back, cover, and splice these new wires on. The package says that these are multifunction, so turn signals and marker lights, so they should flash while the lights are also on and not just stay on and actually flash brighter when you hit the blinker. So we've got a 3-wire and a 2-wire. This 2-wire is usually the one on the outside, but it also flashed, and as you can see here, it's already factory spliced where you got the 3 wires inside here and 3 coming out here to this one, and then 2 of the 3 are spliced already. But the new bulbs, new lights here, all have 3 wires, so the 3rd wire, which will be your ground, will just get mounted on here onto a ground surface, just like any other light. So right now, when you hit the turn signals, they hyper flash, and that's just letting me know the bulbs are out, but it's just those corroded terminals. And when I turn my lights on, usually one of these both actually light up, telling me that the lights are out also. So that's what it does right now. There's also a flasher relay that's plugged up inside the steering column under here. Depends on the year of your Wrangler. Some of them are up top under here, some of them are up underneath. I didn't order that piece yet because I wasn't sure if I had the 5-prong or the 4-prong. I think it's the 4-prong, but I'm gonna wait till I undo and take a look at what I have, and that should be another $20 part. On these metalcloak fenders, you've got 2 holes, one on the front and one on the side for the lights, and they come with little rubber grommets to stick inside here, and that's what's going to hold the light in place. And then these are the lights, LED. And they're all epoxied and sealed here on the inside, so that should be waterproof. We'll see. I went ahead and did the 1st wire after cutting all 3 off of there. This is a crimped female end of the bullet connector. So I'll take another wire now and use my tool. Wire stripper, and I know this is a 14 gauge from, or I'm sorry, 16 gauge. So there's numbers on here. You're gonna stick your wire in there and kind of twist it back and forth and just pull up, and it's gonna strip that outer sheathing off of the wire, exposing the copper underneath, just like this. Just like that. So there's the outer sheathing, and there's the wire. And now here's our female bullet connector. The thinner side is what you're going to stick on here, because the thicker side is what that bullet inserts into to connect on the other side. So you stick this in there, make sure it's in the hole. Take our same tool, and now up here on the top is where you're going to crimp it. So this is the 14 to 16 gauge blue middle one. Right there, and just squeeze. There we go. Now it's not the most effective and strongest like soldering, but it's on there. Check it out. What I did is just temporarily connect these bullet connectors. They kind of pop in and pop out, so I have them barely popped in. And I have white, which is ground according to both directions from Metalcloak and from this Amazon package. So white was ground, so I did white to white. Black is the running lights, so I did black to black. And then red is your turn signal slash brake, so in this case, turn signal. And I connected that to the black and yellow striped wire coming from the Jeep. And that's very bright. I'm gonna go ahead now and hit the blinker. Yep. And that works too. It's hyper flashing. That's because I still need to get that flasher module. I think it's a 4-pin. Well, there we go. Time to do the other one. I'm very impressed. I really love them. They're so bright. $8.99 a piece. I mean, or $8.99 a pair. Can't beat that. As far as the connections, the front one had the three wires. The side one only has two wires. So I've got one here unconnected. And so I've got white ground connected and red blinker connected. This black ground, I think I'm just going to tape this thing up out of the way, because getting back into the stock wiring harness where it kind of V's off to the three and the two prong, this two prong has that soldering here where it takes that striped blinker wire and connects it with this striped blinker wire from the front bulb. So it's kind of a ground, or I'm sorry, it's kind of a running light and a blinker wire. So it's two in one. So this one, I'm just gonna tape up out of the way. And here's the blinkers. Nice and bright. Definitely can see that from the side and the front. And that's with the lights on. It also works with the lights off. No, it doesn't. Yeah, so turn signals don't work unless the lights are actually on. So on your light switch, you can pull it out once and that turns on the marker lights. You can pull it out all the way. That turns on the headlights. So I'm really not too mad about it. If you guys know or way around there, so something that I don't know, I am by no means a wire guy. So in order to use my turn signals, I have to have the running lights on, which really isn't a big deal for me. It's better than having no lights at all in the front for the past few years. So if you have any tips or tricks, go ahead and leave them in the comments.
I've got the wires tucked up under here. And I don't want these connectors really out in the open and the elements getting splashed up and dirty. So I've got them both pushed up underneath there, up inside the fenders, and I'll connect them from here. And I have all this extra wiring so I can connect them right here and then just tuck them away nice and secure. So I got the front one all done. All three bullet connectors punched all the way in. And for that side light that just has two, I'm gonna do the white to white, which is ground. There we go. See that a little better right there? And then this striped one, I'm gonna do with red. And just leave this black one alone. Like I said, I'm not sure what I'm doing wrong, but I know they sell ones that are two-prong. Maybe I needed just a two-prong on that side, but I was just afraid it wasn't going to flash because those say they're not multifunction. But these both flash as long as the lights are on. I'm not too worried. There we go. Same thing now, moving over to the passenger side. First thing I'm gonna do is put the rubber grommets in the holes where the lights are gonna set. Just punch these in there and straighten them out. Kind of just pop in there, make sure they're not bent or stuck. Take one light at a time. And run it through. And a little tricky is getting this to sit in there. You kind of got to push it in there nice and tight. And then once you do that, I'll move on to my wires, just like the other side, three prong and a two prong. So here we go. And that's it. Got the passenger side all buttoned up. The three prong and the two prong. Once again, I got that spare one. Instead of using electrical tape, just because I'm afraid of these crimps getting broken or pulled out of place, I'm gonna get some more liner. This is all dry rotten, flaking apart. I'm gonna run it on each one of these wire connectors just to keep that closed up. There we go. LED turn signals on a Jeep Wrangler.